How much salt do I put in my saltwater tank? Well, first off, you really shouldn't ever be putting salt directly into your saltwater tank, but I'll get into why that is a terrible idea in just a little bit. First, let's answer the question that I think you're trying to get to the bottom of. How much salt do I need to add to the water to make it salty enough for my saltwater fish, corals, and invertebrates? How much salt you're gonna need to add to the water is gonna depend on a few factors. Number one, the salinity or specific gravity, which is a measure of the saltiness that you're trying to achieve. Number two, the mixing instructions that you'll find on the marine salt mix that you're using. And number three, the total volume of water that you're adding the salt to. In terms of how salty the water should be for our reef aquariums, we're typically aiming for a specific gravity of 1.024 to 1.026, which is right around 35 parts per thousand. This is right in line with natural seawater and the correct level for keeping both fish and corals happy. Every type of marine salt mix from every brand is going to have its own set of mixing instructions. The mixing instructions will give you a measure of how much of that particular salt mix you'll need to add to an amount of water in order to achieve a specific salinity. For example, this bag of Aquaphor sea salt has a listed dose of 405 grams of salt per 2.7 gallons of water to achieve a salinity of 35 parts per thousand. We're almost there. Now that we know how much salt needs to be used for that small volume of water, we can now decide how much water we want to mix up and then calculate roughly how much salt we're gonna need using the instructions on the bag. So if I'm gonna mix up around 30 gallons of salt water in my brute container, I'll divide the amount of water I have by 2.7, which works out to 11.1, and then multiply that by the 405 grams of salt, which tells me that I'll need to add roughly 4,500 grams or 4.5 kilograms of this salt to get my 30 gallons of water to a salinity of 35 parts per thousand. After adding that amount of salt and allowing it to mix for as long as the instructions require for it to be fully dissolved, we'll then want to check the salinity of the water using a refractometer or a digital checker. If it's still too low, we can add some salt to get it up to the correct salinity. And if it's too high, we can add some more fresh RODI water to get it down to the correct salinity. Just remember to allow it to mix for a while after adjusting it, and then go back and recheck the salinity to make sure that it is now at the correct salinity. If it's right on the money, then it's ready to go. Now, the reason you don't want to add salt directly to the aquarium, especially if you've already got fish and corals, is because the undissolved salt can burn and damage those inhabitants if it lands on them, making it a really unsafe practice. So just avoid it. And if you need to make changes or adjustments to the salinity in your reef tank, you can do it through water changes over time by gradually increasing the salinity of your fresh saltwater mix. Or if you need to decrease it, just remove small portions of saltwater daily and replace it with fresh RODI water. Just remember to check the salinity every time so you know if you're reaching your target. And that's not the only common mistake that people make when mixing up salt water. There are actually 16 of them, and you can avoid them all by watching this video right here.